The cold and snow of winter begs for a hearty stew, and today we're going to get some tips and shortcuts to make a fantastic beef stew. Here to show us, Terry Schaefer, who is the owner of Love That Olive in Maple Grove. Great to see you again.
Hi.
Good to have you here today. This,
yes.
The fancy name might be beef bourguignon because of some wine that maybe is optional to
exactly.
put in.
Exactly.
You're here to impart some hacks or secrets to making this short.
Just to up your game a little bit.
I love it.
And this is really easy because today we're going to show you in an Instant Pot, but you can make it in the oven or in a crock pot.
Love
easily.
That. Okay.
So all three. So this is really easy. I started out by sauteed our beef, round beef, mm-hmm. and onions to start out with beforehand. And you could do it right in your Instant Pot. And of course, we're going to add a little bit of flour in there, about a quarter cup of it, right over the top.
And that's a little thickening.
Yes. You want to get that to be a stew. You want to have that thickening agent in there. And then we're just going to add a few little things. We're going to add 2 cups of beef consomme, 2 cups of wine. This is Merlot because I like to have a Merlot, but you can use a Sriracha or whatever kind.
And that's a nice hearty wine. It's so good and flavorful.
Yes. Yep. And we're going to use 2 cups of water
nice.
In there. Add a little bit of sea salt and black pepper to it. And this is one of my favorite. We have a prime rib rub. We're going to add about 2 tablespoons in here of the prime rib rub. This brings out all the flavors of the beef, so you want to have that.
So just a few shakes of that.
Yep.
Okay.
And then these are dried scallions, leeks, and shallots, so you have that extra onion flavor.
Nice.
We started out by adding a little bit of the Tuscan herb olive oil in on that beef, and you're going to add a little bit extra. And the Tuscan oil has the rosemary, basil, oregano, dill, garlic, so mm-hmm. all kinds of wonderful flavors. And then the secret ingredient is going to be our aged balsamic. As you can see, it's really thick and rich. You want to do like 3 tablespoons. That, with the wine, brings in that sweetener of that sauce and brings it all around.
That's terrific. So, at Love That Olive, you have been experimenting and using the flavors.
We have.
Using the oils and using the balsamics to be able to integrate all these flavors. This is great.
And it's great.
And then using something like the Instant Pot, it makes this all very fast.
Really
right?
fast. Right. We add our carrots, you add
Let's
your potatoes.
Go ahead. That's good.
All
put
right.
In. That's
We're going to put them in. And then you're just going to put it on your regular setting for 30 minutes. And when you take it out, it comes all together for you. I let it take, you know how you release the steam in the Instant Pot?
Yes.
I let it do naturally. So it does it for 10 minutes. So it does that slow release.
So just let it sit there. I'm learning how to use one
myself.
Yeah,
if you do the slow release, that it'll do it by itself rather than the fast, and it gives little flavors.
Right in
there.
And
then you get this wonderful, wonderful beef stew that's really, really thick.
And look at the broth, and look at how beautiful it looks when it's in there. You have something special coming up this Saturday. It's a special occasion. Tell us about it.
It's our 9th anniversary party
from
10 to 5 on Saturday. And we're going to be featuring comfort foods that you can come in and taste and check out the recipes and things. We're also doing a special. Every year, just for 2 weeks for our birthday, we bring in a special Italian olive oil.
And real quick, where can people find you?
We are right off of Weaver Lake Road across from JCPenney's.
This is Yummo, by the way.
Isn't it
delicious?
Good?
This is great. Borrowing from Rachel
I
Rager.
Love it.
Thank you. You can find this recipe and tips at carolovin.com under the 4 p.m. show page. We're going to be right back.
It's delicious.